Hi, my name is Philip, and I'm the man who will electrify Africa, though I will need your help with that. So you might already know the statistics, but in case you didn't, over 500 million people in Africa don't have access to electricity. In some countries, only around 50% of the population has access, while in others it's as low as 10%. So why is the situation so bad? Well, of course, it's a very complex topic. There's a lot of context that would need to be understood in order to fully answer that question. But I would like to start with some of the technical aspects. And don't worry, I'll do my best to keep it understandable, even if you're not the technical type. Electrifying Africa in the same way the countries of the developed world did in the 20th century, with high voltage transmission grid covering the country, distribution grids in every town and settlement, and large coal power plants powering it all, would be costly, to say the least. On top of that, that last part, the large coal power plants, would be stupid, to put it lightly. In a world where the effects of the climate crisis are severe, and on a continent where sunlight is absent only during the night, wouldn't it make so much more sense to use solar power? Of course, just replacing the power source with solar panels wouldn't even work. There would be a total grid collapse every evening when the sun sets, and on top of that, there would be large amounts of energy, unused energy, during the solar noon. Adding lithium-ion batteries would make the idea feasible, although again, very expensive. Especially in Africa, where temperatures are fairly high, leading to faster battery degradation. Sustainability isn't something we would achieve easily with this approach either, given how lithium mining is done today. As an electrical engineer, I've been thinking about this problem for a little while now. To me, it's clear that the solution needs to be cost-effective, but I also believe that it is important to achieve that without compromising on the user experience. With that in mind, I believe there's a few ideas which are key to achieving these goals of ours. I'd like to talk about the most interesting one in this video, and that is the idea of offloading energy storage from the battery to more direct forms of energy storage wherever possible. Now, in order to understand what I'm talking about here, we need to first understand that it's not electricity itself that we need. It's rather what that electricity can do for us. For example, in the case of a well, typically a modern well would have an electric pump that brings the water up to the surface. One could say that using solar panels to power that pump could be problematic, as people also need water during the night. However, what if instead we use the solar power to store the water up in a tank? Then we can later use this water whenever needed, including during the night. A more interesting example is thermal storage. A fridge could have a separate compartment filled with water that could be frozen while solar power is available, and then later used to refrigerate the food even when solar power is not available. With concepts like these implemented, the battery would only need to cover lighting, personal device charging, and cooking during the nighttime. Cooking is an interesting topic all on its own, and I have a few ideas, so I might make a future video about that. If that sounds interesting to you, make sure you subscribe to not miss it. In any case, with this approach, we've drastically lowered the cost of energy storage without introducing any compromises. Now, we mentioned some numbers earlier, but that can be very abstract, and not having electricity might be difficult to comprehend to most of us that have had it our entire life. So let's talk about that a little bit. This whole idea actually came from discussions with a friend who is from Mali, which is in West Africa. He's also an electrical engineer and is working together with me on this project, and he's also able to provide a lot of valuable insight into the topic. Today in Mali, around 50% of the population doesn't have access to electricity. Where electricity is available, it is not reliable. Power outages are a common enough occurrence that those fortunate enough invest into an alternative power source, usually a diesel generator. In places where there is no electricity, people use gas lamps for lighting and cook with wood or grass. And something that is often surprising to people is that a large part of the population has access to a smartphone. So how do they have their smartphones charged? Well, they have it done as a service by the local guy who has a diesel generator. In summary, there are many ways that electricity could improve the quality of life within the home in Africa. But besides that, it could also pave the way to economic development, to businesses and industries that were otherwise out of reach, further improving the quality of life of the people living in Africa. The lack of development in African countries might not be surprising after centuries of exploitation of the transatlantic slave trade and of colonialism. And as we've seen in recent news, the people of Africa are still fighting for justice. So while they do the best they can on their front, let's do the best we can on ours. As an electrical engineer with a passion for power electronics, I believe that the best way that I can contribute is by developing a system for electrification that incorporates the ideas I have, like the one we talked about earlier. Of course, I alone won't be able to achieve much. And although a few friends have joined me, there's a lot of work that needs to be done. So if you have some skills that you believe could be helpful and would like to contribute, you can start by checking out the links in the description below. If you like our approach and would like to support us, there's a few things you could do. You can help us by donating or becoming a member at one of the links in the description below. Everything we develop as part of this project will be publicly available under an open source license. More on that in the next video. In any case, you can always like the video and share it with your friends and family. We will need to reach a lot of people, so that would be a major help. We'll make sure to keep you up to date on this channel, so make sure you subscribe if you're interested. We also have Rose of Engineering, a channel with a more technical focus if you would be interested in that stuff. If you have any questions or things you would like to discuss, drop a comment down below. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.